Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and I was going to do a special video here today because this is something I'm really proud of and really excited to talk about, but I kind of want to just do the normal Better Computer thing and give you an overview of the app and show you how it works, and I feel like that's what I do best, and so let's not do a big announcement video. Let's just look at this app that I made. The app is called Quick Reviews, and it's a way to create really nice, really beautiful images that you can share on social media for reviewing whatever you want. Movies, TVs, TV shows, books, games, whatever. This is the web app that's been around for quite a while, and it's pretty basic, but has some cool stuff. And you can see this is a review that I created for The Matrix, and there's a command bar that lets you do some cool stuff. I can copy the text to my clipboard, I can save it to my downloads folder, and boom, there you go, I can share that to social media. This is really nice, however, one of the limitations is that you have to bring all your own stuff. You have to type out the name, the directors, the review itself, and then you kind of have to find the poster to go along with this and then copy it in here or drag it in, whatever. Really good, but some manual work. So I have made an iOS version of this that is pretty darn solid and has become my way of using Quick Reviews, which again, this is all very strange because it's my app, but I do think I got to a pretty good place with this initial release. So let's take a look at it. So the first thing you're going to notice is it has a very different first screen than Quick Reviews on the web, right? Quick Reviews on the app or on the web just takes you straight to the movie, and that's kind of it. On the app, it's going to show you a history. Now, the history has never been there on the web app, but this basically lets you see a full history of everything you've reviewed in the app and lets you kind of go back to it, lets you reshare the image that you posted to social media. I should also say, well, I didn't explicitly say it, but the image is this. This is what you'll get, and you can post it on social media, and it'll be great. Let's go to Mastodon, actually. I could probably find a lot of people have been using it, so people have been sharing little bits. Here's someone did for season one of Severance. Here's someone for Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. This is one I did for Castlevania on Netflix. Someone doing a video game through it, so quite a few reviews here. Someone doing Silo Season 2. So yeah, I reviewed Kid A just for fun to kind of show one of the new styles. The Order is a movie that was very good. I really enjoyed this one. You should check that out. But anyway, this is the sort of thing that it generates. And you can post these to Mastodon, Blue Sky, Threads, X, wherever you're using social media, this will work. But anyway, let's generate one and give you an idea for how the experience is. So we're going to write a review, and what are we going to do? Let's do a review for Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. So let's just do The Two Towers. Normally I'd write pretty much the whole title, but Magic Mode, which is a new exclusive feature to the mobile app, is going to help me with this. So I'm going to just hit continue, and within a second, it autofills Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers, released in 2002, directed by Peter Jackson, and it pulls in the artwork for me. This is so nice. I'm so glad I was able to implement this into the app. It makes creating these reviews super, super simple. If it does get it wrong, and it will get it wrong sometimes because I can't read your mind, I can make an educated guess to what you're looking for, but can't always get it right. If it gets it wrong, hit Fix Movie Selection. Any other results that came up from whatever you entered will show here, and you can change it to that. It's correct, so I'm just going to leave it here. If you don't like the poster, when using Magic Mode, you can see alternate posters. And here's up, it'll show up to 16 alternate posters for the movie or TV show. It works with TV shows as well. Let's go with this guy. I like this one of Gollum. So that's the poster. I'm going to say I loved this. And then I'm going to say this movie rocked. And I'm just going to do that a few times to make it a little longer. Now we can go ahead and save. We've saved the review, and now we get into the design portion of it. Let's make it look how we want. So I can just, if I'm happy with how it is, I can just go ahead and save it to photos, share it with the share sheet, or copy to my clipboard, whichever I prefer. But let's look at the colors first. So the first thing you're going to notice is that there are some default automatic color suggestions here. So by default, you have a theme. We'll look at that in the settings, but you can change the color based on colors in the poster. So here's the options it gives me. I kind of like this one. This seems the closest. This kind of matches nicely with that. I can increment whatever color is selected to be a little darker, a little lighter, but I actually think that middle one nailed it. That is perfect. That's what I want it to be. I do think this green isn't quite right for the tone of this. So I could use the, I can I hit the score color selector, and I can use the eyedropper to select something from the poster, but in this case, I'm just gonna make it white. There we go, and I think this looks pretty good. This is like something I would wanna share, except the text size is a little wrong. The two towers, it's too long. I do try to do some logic here to resize the text to fit, but this is just too long. So let's go to the text customization, reduce the title size a little bit. Just one increment down seems to have fixed it, so now that's good. The metadata, I could actually make this a little bigger, a little smaller, whatever I want. I think it's actually kind of okay. And we're good. This is what I want to share, so let's go to export. We're going to save to photos, and it's saved and it said text copied. We'll get into why it did that in a second. That is not on by default, but it is something that I like to use. Basically, now I have that documented here, right? Really, really nice. Just to show you real quick that it works with other things, let's do Game of Thrones. That is a TV show. Magic Mode also works with TV. It only works with movies and TV right now. I'd like to expand it to the other ones, but it's not there yet. You can also review games, books, music, or just other if it's something totally else, but this should fix it for me. Great. Let's see alternate posters. I like this one. There we go. So now I have my poster, blah, blah, blah. I actually loved it overall, even though the last couple seasons weren't as good. And so then we go into the colors again. It's going to pull different colors based on kind of the gold and brown and black that they've got there. So again, I can kind of tweak this to whatever I think looks good and change the colors, change the text and all that. And when I'm done, I'm done and it's on the list. Let's delete that one just because we don't need it. Real quick before we jump into the settings, you also have a history here. So here's all the things I've watched and I can filter through them. So if I want to see all the times I watched Lord of the Rings, oops, I should type it correctly. Lord of the Rings, not rungs. Oh boy, rings. There we go. Here's all those. I can see them. I can see when I watched. It's been over 3 years since I watched Fellowship of the Ring. I think it's time for me to actually get back on that. Another use case for this I really like is at the end of the year, if you wanted to make like a top 10 list of movies, for example, you could go look at movies from the last year that you said you loved, done, and there they all are. Here's all the movies you said you loved in the app, and you can find a top 10 list from here most likely. So really like that. We're going to clear the filters so the full history is there, and let's go into the settings. So in the settings, we have the subscription at the top. So this app is free and you can do most things for free. The ones that are blocked behind the paywall are Magic Mode. So that's the thing that was automatically pulling in all the title information, the metadata, the posters, all that is locked behind Magic Mode. I do use third-party services that could cost me real money if they're used, especially at scale. So I need to have a subscription to make it reasonable. But basically you can choose what elements you want Magic Mode to pull in for you. You don't have to do posters if you don't want. If you want to do your own metadata, you can turn that off. We also have a fun one here for suggest score. So by default, there'll just be, I think a 3 out of 4 will be the suggested review score. But if you turn this on, if we go back here and do a review for, let's say, Battlefield Earth, it's going to assume I'm going to say I didn't like it. Whereas if I do a search for, let's do the Two Towers again, it's going to assume I loved it, right? And so this is just based on the Rotten Tomatoes score. I don't personally use this, but I think it's kind of a fun little thing you can turn on if you want. You can import your history from Letterboxd if you have a premium subscription. You can here's the instructions. You go to Letterboxd and export your data. There's a reviews.csv file that you can then import with this button. It'll just use the file picker from iOS, and you can import all those reviews. There is unlimited review history as well. So if you don't pay, if you're just using the app for free, you get the last 30 days of history. If you pay and turn this on, it'll turn on by default once you subscribe. But if you have this on, it will keep an unlimited history for you so you can keep a full history. Other than that, it's just some pretty basic stuff. You can change the accent color of the app to anything on this list. There's some nice options there. You can make the appearance match your phone or force dark mode or light mode, whichever you prefer. And you can change the default media type. So if I'm typically using this to review books, for example, if I go back to the home screen and say write a review, it's going to assume book. I can change it, of course, to any other ones, but it'll set the default for me. So if I'm always doing one type of media, I can make sure it's just a little more convenient to use. You saw when we edited the review that we can change the font, we can change the colors and everything, but you can change the defaults here. So what do you want the default font to be? There's quite a few fonts here. You can change it to whatever's here. I'd like to make this list a little better in the future. You can change your default colors. So the default theme I think looks pretty good, but you could also do kind of this light theme. You can do this candy theme. There's some really nice ones here that I had from the web app that I think hold up pretty well and are good starting points for a lot of people. I'll just go back to the default one. You can change the labels. So loved it, liked it, decent, didn't like it are here, but you can also just change it to a star system. You can change it to a thumb system. And these are just text fields. So you can type, whoa, as your review, and that'll change what the best one is. I like this system because it's really personal. I loved it. I liked it. I thought it was decent. I didn't like it. And it isn't like a objective score. It's just how I felt about it. Show media type icon that controls at the top right of the reviews. If we go back to this, you can see there's a little film icon up here. It'll change based on the media type. That will, you don't have to use that. You could just turn it off there. Clipboard detection. So automatic clipboard detection, it's described down here, but basically if you have an image on your clipboard when you start a review, we're going to assume you copied a poster to your clipboard and you want to use that. So we won't use magic mode. We'll just use whatever that image is. You can also just say no in the moment to not allow access to your clipboard and it won't happen. And copy to clipboard, that's after you've exported the review. It'll copy the review text to your clipboard so that you can easily add it as alt text. When you post it to social media, you can see on this image, for example, if you can't see well, you're not gonna be able to see this image and you may want to know what I said. You can see if I hover over it, the alt text displays. And so someone using a screen reader would be able to use that to read the image without being able to see it. So that's cool. Finally, there's some data stuff. You can export your reviews as a JSON file. You can import them, that same JSON file. So it's really an internal thing. This won't be useful for any other services, but if you want to export your data and import it on a different device, you can do that. And you can always clear all your reviews if you just want to empty everything out. As of right now, none of these reviews sync using any services. I would like to add iCloud sync in the future, but sync is very complicated even if you're using iCloud. And so I want to make sure I get that right. As of right now, if you're moving to a different device or something, you just want to do an export and then import on the new device. And that's pretty much it. I didn't mention the pricing. The pricing is $9 per year, $10 per year, $9.99. And that gets you access to all these features. I will try to add more, but I can't promise anything. As many people will say, don't buy something based on what you'll be able to do in the future with it. Buy it based on what you can get today. So magic mode, I think, is the real big thing here, but unlimited review history and the Letterboxd import, especially if you've been using Letterboxd to review things for years. That's how I got so much history into here. I was able to just import everything from Letterboxd and it kind of gave me a nice starting point. So yeah, that is it for quick reviews. I think it's a really nice little app that does something very specific that I need personally, and I know not everybody else will, but hopefully this will help people get some stuff done that they weren't able to do before, or introduce them to this idea of posting these quick little reviews online. I think it's really fun and I like seeing other people do it. So thank you so much for watching. Link in the show notes to the App Store listing for it. And yeah, thank you so much. Bye.